In this episode, we're going to take a step back. Back to one of the most important tasks when you work as a GrandMA3 programmer. This GrandMA3 tutorial is all about the merge, override, and remove function you use when you start to make some actual programming. Understanding those functions is something you must master if you want to work as a GrandMA3 programmer. Storing something into a sequence is easy and something everybody can do, but removing values from your GrandMA3 sequences and queues is equally important, and it's something you have to know to be a fast and good GrandMA3 programmer. So without further ado, let's just get into it. First, let's look at the GrandMA3 merge function. The merge function will prompt you if you are trying to store something into an already existing queue. As you can see, I prepared a little scene for us here with a lot of, this time, mega points. Let's just select all of them, like this, and turn them on at full, and maybe put them into a position. So this is basically just normal. You put in some lights in a position and you turn them on, you want to store it somewhere. So let's just store this into our sequence right here, and as you can see, it created queue number one. If we clear this scene and we go this queue list, you can see we now have all our mega points. Let's do the same for our two lights and put some two lights on at full, like this. You can see they're up right now. Once again, we can simply store this into the same sequence, and it's going to ask us, what do you want to do? In this case, I want to merge it into the same queue as I'm in already. So if I just press merge and I clear my console, you can see everything is now into our master sequence. And this is basically the most simple function ever. This is merge. You can put something on top of other things into your sequence. And that is very, very easy to do. You will find yourself merging into queues all the time as a GrandMA3 programmer. Now we master the merge function, and in a minute we'll take a look at the GrandMA3 override function. But just before we do that, if you like this content and get any value out of this video, be sure to give it a like. Liking the videos is a free and good way to support any YouTube channel. With that out of the way, let's just continue. Let's take a look at option number two. When you store into an existing queue on a GrandMA3 console. This time we're going to talk about the override function. So the override function takes something and replaces it with something else. That's basically what's happening here. So let's just take all our two lights here and just turn them off and store that into our sequence right here. And let's just merge it in for now. We clear it out and as you can see, all the two lights are gone again. Now we have all our mega points on and all our two lights off. Let's say we turn all our two lights on again and we say store into queue number one and we say override. As you can see, all the mega points disappeared and all the two lights are left. We clear out here and you can simply see everything we put into our programmer. We stored that into the queue and we removed everything else that was already in the queue. That is basically how the override function works. The override function works if you take something into your programmer and you say, okay, this is my new queue. I know my queue was like this before, but now this is the way I want it. You can simply store it into your queue and say override. It replaces everything with the new look you just made. Next up is the remove function. But before that, I'll urge you to leave a comment below if you have any questions or comments to this video. I'd love to help you if you get stuck with something in these GrandMA3 tutorial videos. And check out the links below if you want to look at some real GrandMA3 hardware. It'll tell you what you need to know in terms of what the different models have to offer. But last but not least, let's look at the remove option. Removing values from your queues is just as important as merging them into your queues in the first place. Knowing how the GrandMA3 console removes values from your queues will help you later down the line when you must change something in your existing programming, and it'll help you when you start learning about tracking on the GrandMA3 console. We'll not get into tracking in this tutorial, but we definitely will in one of the next episodes. Just remember that tracking is really important. Removing values is really important, and as you can see here, we simply just continue with all our two lights. They are all turned on. If we want to remove some of them out of our programming, we could simply just start by taking them like this and we could turn them off. But if we turn them off, we still have a hard value recorded into our cue. And this is not what we need. We want to remove the value completely. So right now they are turned off, and that means the dimmer is active, and we can now remove the active parameter. And since the dimmer is active right now, we can simply say store into the cue we just made, and we can say remove. And when we clear this, you can see they're gone, and they're completely gone from this one. All the values are completely gone in the sequence sheet, or sorry, the fixture sheet up here. So this is basically how you remove values. And as I said, tracking is really important. And in one of the next episodes, we're going to look at tracking, because this is something you really have to know, how to remove values and add values and make sure that it tracks in the right order. But that's for another video. I hope this video gives you a better understanding of what you need to do when you are working with creating your GrandMA3 show. You have to know to get values into your sequences, but it's equally important to be able to remove values as well. If you want to know more about working with the GrandMA3 console, check out this next video linked on the screen right now, where I will show you even more tips and tricks you need as a GrandMA3 programmer. But until I see you the next time, happy GrandMA3 programming.